behind me, I have the weighted air hoses just blowing in the water. And that was because the fish were starting to die because the algae was building up too much. So I went ahead and did that to get that going. I have the do-it-yourself diffusers here. Now I'm gonna get a bag of concrete and then pour some water into the bottom of this, trying not to get it on the diffuser itself. Here I have a Type S mortar mix. I'm just using what I got. So I'm gonna pour it into here first. Then carefully pour it into each of the buckets. I have them filled up about a third full, and I'm just gonna carefully pour some water into it. Now I'm going to pull the air hose in and hook these up. Then I'll get in the boat and lower them down to where they need to go. There we go. Now this one's only 50 feet long. Okay, now I'm going to tie this rope onto the bucket handle. Okay, so I'm gonna hop on the boat and we're gonna locate this one. We're gonna add the swan decoy.
Nothing like doing a splits. Whew. Slippery. Okay, let's this down in there. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is tie a loop in this. I'm going to tie one more loop in it. Then I'm going to take this zip tie and zip tie it. And at another date, I'll double it up. And there we go, we have a swan in the water. Now let's go back. And let's get the other one. Let's get the duck in the water. There we go. And here's the duck. And let me just tie it one more knot. And here we go.
So, hope you enjoyed that. I'll be slicing the video together, so you should be able to see it from most angles. Went in really well. Now they said that 6 feet, you really should try to aim for 6 feet or less on the depth, but it seems to be working pretty well right now, so I'll try to get some better footage during the daytime, show it in action. But thanks for watching this video and hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to check out High Blow Pond, or well, they're aerators that I use for a pond. They're really for septic systems or tanks. So thanks for watching.
Just a little update. I did cover this with this box, and there's a big opening for the air to go in there. And then down here, I ended up adding a ball valve on the high side, or the shallow side of the setup. That way, air is able to go to this side as well as that side. So then during the winter, just need to make sure that that is down below there in the water, and it can be adjusted, and it's doing great.